In this lecture, I want to talk to you about using wildcards with your queries. Now, I'm sure that you've created a query, and maybe you're looking for something specific. So maybe you're looking for all of the customers from a certain city, or all of the orders that were placed on a certain date. Well, in those cases, you know that you can come to the grid in your query window and head on down to criteria and type in the specific city that you're looking for, or even the specific order date that you're looking for. But what if you're looking for a range of dates for orders? Or what if you don't know exactly what city you're looking for? In those cases, you definitely want to use wildcards. Now, in the resources section for this lecture, you're going to find a document that talks about wildcards. So take a look at that and use that to follow along. All right, so in this first example, let's say that I'm looking for orders for a specific date. Let's say that order date was September 4th, 2015. So I'll go ahead and type that here in the criteria. Now, for dates, they need to be surrounded by the pound sign or the hash mark. So I'll start that, and I'll go ahead and type in September 4th, 2015, and close my hash mark. That looks good. I'll go ahead and run it. And there's my order from September 4th. All right, let me head on back to design view. Because what if now I want to see all of the orders from a range of dates? What if I want to see the orders from September 1st to September 4th? Well, in that case, I'd have to use the between and operator. And this is how to do it. So in my order date field, again, I want to see the orders between September 1st and September 4th. So under order date, I'll go ahead and type in between. Now, I typed it in all caps here so it's easier to read, but it's not case sensitive. And then I'll put in September 1st. So again, surrounded by hash marks, I'll put in September 1st of 2015. And then the keyword of and. So this is what's going to create a range for my dates. All right, now when I go and run this, I have two orders between September 1st and September 4th. All right, let me head on back again to design view. And you can also use functions inside of your criteria. So what if I wanted to see the most recent orders? What if I wanted to see all the orders that were placed in the last 7 days? Well, I'll go ahead and get rid of that last criteria I put in. And this time, I'm going to type in greater than, and then the date function, which is the word date, followed by an open and a close parentheses, minus 7. I want to see all the orders from the past 7 days. So I'll go ahead and run that, and there they are. All right, heading back to design view. I'll go ahead and get rid of that criteria. And if you want to find records that are missing certain information, then you can use isNull, I-S-N-U-L-L. So maybe I want to find all of the orders that have not yet shipped. So what I'll do is under the orders table, I'll go ahead and add in the shipped date. Now, of course, if these orders have a ship date, then it's been shipped. But if there's nothing in that field, then the orders haven't been shipped yet. So for shipped date, I'll come down to the criteria, and I'll type in is null. All right, I'll go ahead and run that. And I've got 9 orders here that have never shipped. My shipped date column is null. There's nothing in there. Okay, let me show you some more examples. So here I have a query, and it's using my order details and my products table. Here I'm just pulling out the order ID and the name of the product. Well, I want to see the chocolate products that were sold. And there's a couple of different chocolate products. There's the chocolate biscuit mix, and then there's just the regular old bar chocolate. So I wouldn't want to come in here and under criteria type out the full name. I just want to type in chocolate. Since the name of both products have the word chocolate in them, I just want to type out chocolate and then have the system find for me everything with chocolate in the name. So because I'm not looking for exactly chocolate, but I'm looking for something that has like chocolate in it, then I want to use like. If you're not looking for something specific as far as text goes, then you would use like. So I'm going to be looking for something like chocolate. All right, so under the product name in criteria, I'll give a click there and type in like. And then since I'm working with text inside of double quotes, I want to put in chocolate. But here's the thing. There may be some characters before the word chocolate, or there may be some characters after the word chocolate. I don't know. So I have to tell Access to return for me any record that has chocolate in it, that contains chocolate. So here I'm going to use the asterisk wildcard. The asterisk means any number of characters or no characters at all. So I'm going to type in asterisk and then chocolate and then another asterisk because there may or may not be more characters after the word. And then I'll close my quote. All right, let me go ahead and run this. So there are my orders or my sales, and there are the chocolate items for those orders. Let me switch back to design view. So again, use like in your criteria when you don't know exactly what you're looking for, but you know it's like something. In this case, it's like chocolate. All right, let me head over to my other query. And this one is simply made from the employees table. Right now I'm pulling out all the fields from the table, and that's noted here by the asterisk. But what I want to do here is to pull out records by employee's last name. So I'll double click on last name. Now, I'm going to use last name as a criteria, but I don't want this field to actually show a second time here in my results set. So I'm going to uncheck show. I'm just using it as a criteria. And here, maybe I want to find all the employees whose last names begin with, say, A through L. So again, I'm not looking for something specific, but I want something like A through L. So I'll start with like, and then again, I'm looking for text, so I need my double quotes. And here, to find a range of letters, I'm going to use square brackets. So I'll type in a square bracket there, and I'm looking for A through L. So I'll type in an A, a dash, and an L. All right, I'll go ahead and close my square brackets. Now here I'm looking for all the names that start with A through L. So I need to add an asterisk. And again, the asterisk means any number of characters or no characters at all. So it's going to start with A through L and then have a certain number, an unknown number of characters after that. All right, I'll close my double quotes and hit run. And there are all my employees, A through L for the last name. I'll head on back to design view. Now, if I were looking for employees whose last name started with M through Z, I could come down here and type M through Z, or I can use the exclamation point. The exclamation point means not. So I could come right in, right before the A, after my opening square bracket, and type in an exclamation point. So now when I go ahead and run this, there are my employees who are M through Z. All right, back in design view, something else I could have done, let me go ahead and get rid of that bang symbol there, exclamation point. I could have just typed in the word not. So here I've got like A through L, but I also could have typed in not like A through L. So when I run that, again, I get the same results, M through Z. So those are just a few ways that you can use wildcards here for the criteria of your queries. And again, take a look at the document that's in the resources section. It's going to have a few more examples for you.